Quartermaster. Welcome to Skylands, a magical world of wonder and adventure, ruled by the greatest heroic emperor ever known.
Me!
Centuries, meddling do-gooder portal masters like you have been sending their miserable Skylanders to stop me and hold back the gloriously evil power of the darkness. But no more! Because now the portals are under the complete and utter control of Bum-Bum-Bum! Me! Chaos! And in case you foolish human fools haven't figured it out yet, I'm the bad guy. Glorious, isn't it? But wait, there's more. Because I've taken the opportunity to capture anyone in Skylands who could have even remotely, possibly helped you. Anywho, now that I control the portals, I am cutting you off from Skylands. For good! With no more Skylands to go back to, your Skylanders will simply be the helpless toys I've always known them to be. So long, Poser Master. Forever!
Portal override protocols commencing.
Hugo.
Not yet, Flynn.
Well, are you sure you're doing it right?
Shh, wait. I think I've got something. Portalmaster, is that you? Can you hear me? If you can hear this message, please place the supercharger vehicle on the portal. Only this special vehicle we sent you can unlock this secret message. You have to put a vehicle on the portal to get to Skylands. Please place a vehicle on the portal and come to Skylands. Hurry!
Rift engine detected. Portal override complete. Launch sequence engaged.
It's working! The vehicle is opening a rift into Skylands!
Hot streak! Fear the fish! Yes!
Alright, Skylander. I'm picking you up on my supercharger tracking device. I'll help guide you, but you must hurry! Use the accelerator button to go! And you can steer using the left stick. It's working, Hugo! They're not in the clear yet, Callie. The entire portal network is highly unstable and very dangerous thanks to chaos. Fortunately, I've rigged my tracking device to help stabilize it.
Woohoo!
Stability is what you need. Let me hold it!
Flynn, no! I lost them. Hang on, Skylander. I'm trying to relocate your signal. There we go. Back on track and heading for Skylands.
I get it now! Let me try again!
Wait! Don't! Uh-oh! The portal is collapsing! Hurry, Skylander! Hurry! You're almost here, Skylander! Initiating visual uplink for the final approach. Visual uplink?
I can't believe it actually
actually worked.
Yeah, let me see. Wowzers, hey there, Skylander buddy. You know, if you need some pointers driving that thing, I'm your guy.
Can we hurry this up, please, Flynn?
Relax, Callie, sheesh. Just giving the Skylander a little FaceTime with yours truly.
Oh, there's a guard.
Oh, all clear, Hugo.
Listen, we're being held on a transport ship that's headed for who knows where.
I heard of that place. They've got great guacamole.
Hush, Flynn. I'm trying to match the destination coordinates of the vehicle to our holding cell.
Quick, they're coming back.
Hurry, you're the only one that can save us.
Greetings, prisoners. This is your captain speaking. On behalf of our supreme and glorious Emperor, Lord Chaos, welcome aboard. I'm sure you'll find your stay here most unpleasant.
Go fish!
As you can see, I have turned on the fasten cell door sign. Please avoid moving about the ship and using the jump button to vault over objects.
Who's there?
Treasure. Quiet.
Lava Lance Eruptor.
Saving us, there are other prisoners on this ship that could use your help, too.
Hugo's right. We should probably do something about that. Right? Because that's what heroes like us do. Boom!
There must be a main flagship that's controlling the fleet. If we can reach it, maybe we can override the controls and save everyone.
That sounds awesome. Let's totally do that.
All right, Skylander. Let's get topside to take a look around and get our bearings.
You'll have to break through that lock to get out of this detention level.
Money!
This is a live wire lock. Use the left stick to move the gremlin through the lock. Collect bolts to earn additional stardust. Just increased your Portal Master rank. Earn Stardust to keep ranking up. Choose one of these Portal Master powers.
Oh, what's happening?
Well, Callie, in my expert opinion, I'd say that big head-looking thingy is gobbling up the sky.
This is terrible! I sure wish Master Eon was here. Wait! I almost forgot! Master Eon left this with me. He said it was for the Skylander. Master Eon?
Greetings, Portal Master. If you are seeing this, I have been taken captive, and my worst fears are confirmed. Thanks to chaos, the darkness has returned, and Skylands now faces its greatest threat. Chaos has used the power of the darkness to construct an evil monstrosity of destruction. Thus, to combat this, we have assembled a special team of Skylanders to pilot an unstoppable fleet of supercharged vehicles, all powered by the legendary Rift engines. They have been sent to you. You must use these superchargers to stop chaos and the darkness before it is too late. Good luck, Portal Master.
How are we gonna stop chaos and the darkness without Master Eon?
Hey, don't worry about all that, Hugo. That Sky Eater thingy will probably eat us all first.
What?
Flynn!
What? I'm just saying. I mean, look at it.
Don't worry, Hugo. We're still together, and I promise we'll find a way to rescue Eon. But first, we need to reach that flagship and save these prisoners. Right, Flynn?
That does sound a whole lot better than being eaten, although I'm pretty sure I am delicious. Either way, count me in. Boom! Sky Eater thingy is so scary.
Some people are in trouble!
You wanna give a letterhead over here?
We can't hold on forever!
We have to do something! You have to help them before they get pulled into that rift, Skylander! This is a land vehicle, Doc. You'll need to use a land vehicle to save the pit crew.
Quite the lure! Woohoo! Yes!
Be
feet are getting tired over here!
Oh, yeah, that's what I'm talking about!
Iron Equalizer.
Take them down, Skylander!
Use the attack buttons on your supercharger!
Useful!
Where it's a chest that might contain a new mod for your vehicle.
Snatch it up, Skylander! It'll give you a boost!
Shadow.
Yeah!
Supercharger Skylanders can press the customization button to customize your vehicle at any time. Things are getting pretty unstable up here, Skylander. You better head back to the fleet. Hurry!
Meet us in the Sky Hangar. You'll find it. We're going to try and track down our ship.
Woohoo! All right!
Isn't something supposed to be happening right now?
Yeah, but this is the part that Master Eon always does.
Well, he's kind of captured at the moment.
Don't worry, I got this. Skylanders of the Earth element are, better in this zone. Or, maybe it was taller.
Oh. Hugo, come on, you can do this.
Okay, here goes. Vehicles of the Earth element are stronger in this zone.
Great job, Hugo.
My version was better.
Dive Bomber.
Champ, go and track down Kelly and the others.
Skylanders of the air element are stronger in this zone.
You managed to escape too, eh, Skylander? Name's Prawn. James Prawn. I was going to try to slow the ship down by clogging up that fuel pump, but I'm having second thoughts about swimming in orange liquid. You understand, right? Yeah, I'll tell you what. I'll stand by to advise while you disable the pump. And try not to splash me. Sound good? You'll need to use a sea vehicle to take on this mission, Skylander.
Reef Ripper. Supercharged.
Thank you.
Reef Ripper.
Levels 3 through 16 have been activated. Initiating deployment sequence.
Oh.
special message.
Skylanders of the undead element are stronger in this zone.
Are going after the escape pods. We can't let him harm those prisoners. You'll need to use a sky vehicle to take down those fighter ships.
There's still prisoners on the lead flagship, Skylander. Once you reach it, I can override the controls and we can save everyone.
Hot streak.
This is our only chance to get everyone out of here. Good luck.
Vehicles of the Earth element are stronger in this zone.
Yeah, Lord Chaos, sir. I mean, I know the station is fueled by the magic it consumes, but are you sure it's supposed to rip big holes in the sky like that?
Nonsense! Of course I'm sure!
It's, not just the holes, sir. Some of the other trolls have been complaining.
About me? What did they say? Don't you wait!
Oh, no, not about you, sir. It's about the, thing.
Eh? Don't be ridiculous, Glumshanks. That's just the darkness.
Yes, I know, sir. But haven't you noticed? It's gotten so much bigger. Plus, I think it's watching me.
Oh, you're imagining things, Glumshanks. Now get me Moneybone.
Very well. Moneybone on line one for you, sir.
Find out where they took my ship before Chaos...
What?
Lord Chaos! What do I owe the esteemed pleasure of your sudden and glorious interruption?
You're late with your 30-minute status update on my favorite prisoner. Is he suffering?
Oh, yes! Enormously! Your rebelliously gaseous enemy, Eon, is languishing in his cell. Nothing will stand in the way of our total victory!
Say, don't you mean my total victory?
Of course! Of course! How boneheaded of me!
Yes, I thought so. Very well! Carry on, Moneybone! You see that, Glumshanks? That is how you handle your minions. soon all of Skylands will fear and obey me, and the glorious reign of Emperor Chaos will begin!
There it is! The Skylander Academy! We made it! And look, there's Buzz!
Skylander Academy used to stand for Training, Excellence, and Super Ninja Commando Skills. But in these dark times, people need a symbol of hope. And that's just what we're gonna be! We need to stay on the move and keep the Core of Light safe from chaos at all costs. Fire up them engines!
I never thought I'd see the Academy again. Thank you, Skylander. It might be a little worse for wear, but Buzz is right. It's the last symbol of hope for Skylands. It's up to us to keep everyone safe. Speaking of which, I need to get to work. Master Eon is still being held prisoner, and we need him now more than ever. But don't worry, Mag said she'd be happy to show you around.
Streak.
Fear the fish. Woohoo!
You're looking exceedingly awesome today.
Your turn. Malifor. Brawlrus. Your turn. Flitter Glimmer. Taekwon Crow. Overdrive ready. Hot Streak. Overdrive ready. Your turn. Tessa. Smoke Scream. Your turn. Captain Bristle Stash. Golden Queen. Drive ready. Hot hot streak.
Kablam!
Victory. Ripper. Supercharged. Your turn. Electroclops. Chompy Mage. Your turn. Wheel lock. Malifor. Overdrive ready. Reef Ripper. Overdrive ready. Chaos. Your turn. Glumshanks.
All right.
Your turn. Sharp Fin. Gotcha. Magic Spell Punk. Gotcha. Overdrive ready. Pendergast.
Start your engines!
Threat Pack. Your turn. Tessa. Overdrive ready. Your turn. Reef Ripper. Wolfgang. Defeated. Your turn. Blubberbeard. The Gulper. Your turn. Wheel lock. Golden Queen. Overdrive ready. Reef Ripper. Overdrive ready. Your turn. Lord Stratosphere. Cuckoo Clocker. Your turn. Pendergast.
Start your engines!
I-5. Overdrive ready. Reef Ripper. Overdrive ready. Victory. Streak.
It's race time here at the Dragon Spine. This mysterious mountainous region is home to the mighty slumbering serpents. Uh-oh, what's this? Chaos's forces are invading the area? Let's hope they don't wake them up, or you could be in big trouble!
Woohoo!
It's spring here in the enchanted halls of the mystical vault. There's something magical in the air. Either that or it's allergy season, because the Enchant-a-Planta can't stop sneezing! See if you can use these energy fluctuations to your advantage during the race!
Ready. 3, 2, 1.
Boom!
Woohoo!
Giving it my best!
Ha!
Reef Ripper. Supercharged.
EA Sports, it's in the game.
You've got one guy going boom, the other guy going whap, and the guy trying to run it in for the score, and he's going nowhere.
Cause I'm on a mission, put me in the game. Cause the way I'm feeling, I honestly do not see no competition. I gotta get it, so it ain't no quitting.
Madden Football is the home of Super Bowl 57, and this historic matchup is brought to you by EA Sports. It's the Kansas City Chiefs and the Philadelphia Eagles, and it comes your way next.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. We count down to kickoff and what should be an epic one here, as it'll be the AFC champion Kansas City Chiefs taking on the NFC champions, the Philadelphia Eagles.
Brandon Gaudin alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, for these Kansas City Chiefs, they, of course, were Super Bowl champions 3 years ago, the win over the Niners in Miami. They fell to the Bucs in Tampa a couple years back. They had the blown lead in the AFC title game against Cincinnati last year. And now they're back, making their third trip to the big game in 4 years.
And their recent history only increases the urgency to try and win another Super Bowl title with this group.
Meanwhile, it took until Super Bowl 52 for the Eagles to lift the Lombardi Trophy for the first time, and not too many players are left from that squad 5 years ago, but this new group is looking to write a new chapter of Eagles lore.
Yeah, we certainly all remember that performance in the win over New England. Nick Foles throwing for 373 yards, catching the Philly special that will go down as one of the most iconic play calls in Super Bowl history. Now they're back and looking to make it two titles in 6 years.
the talk is over. We're set for the big one. Super Bowl 57. Away we go from Arizona. Fields it right around the goal line. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. Philly's offense getting ready, and Jalen Hurts ready to lead them. The second-round pick who started his career at Alabama, then finished with an electric senior season at Oklahoma.
I think we all heard about it in the offseason. There were many questions asking if Philadelphia might consider bringing in another quarterback to replace Jalen Hurts. He answered emphatically, "This is my team," and he led them to a Super Bowl appearance. A well-deserved moment for this quarterback who just kept his head down, kept working, and eliminated all the noise.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. First play, and Hurts looking to throw it. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Brown. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 14 yards there on the first play from scrimmage. Well, they brought the pressure, and that meant man coverage behind him, so he's still able to complete the pass.
Even as he took the hit, and that's what you have to do, because I was just talking with a coach the other day, and he said, look, it's not always going to be pretty back there. You're going to have to give me completions. Even when you're taking some hits, sometimes you have to be your own blitz control, for lack of a better term. Got to make completions, step up and make those throws, and he did that.
They'll fake the give to Sanders, and now Hurts. Flushed out right. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
I certainly like what he did right there, because he smartly wanted to avoid forcing anything downfield because nothing appeared to be open. Nice harmless slide there to avoid the big hit, and he gets a small gain on the play.
Miles Sanders, first carry of the game. And he'll take it across the 50 and into Chief territory.
Well, at that rate, picking up 3 yards of carry, you and I both know that doesn't cut it in this league and trying to get first downs, unless you're playing four-down football. Then that's a whole different situation. But I don't think that's what they're trying to do here. Third and four, though, is still manageable.
In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Here's Hurts to throw. And that is incomplete.
I know tight ends love this route because a lot of times they'll fake a block first and get a little bit of space and then come across the middle, because in their mind, they're thinking catch the ball and then drop the hammer on the little guys in the secondary.
Unable to drop the hammer, he just dropped the pass. On fourth down, here's Brett Kern to punt the football away. Back deep is Kadarius Toney. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. The KC offense set to go, led as always by the gunslinger, a former MVP in this league. It's Patrick Mahomes.
You can't help but continue to marvel at how well this man's career has gone so far. Now in his fifth season as KC starter, he's never missed a conference title game, and he's taking the field in his third Super Bowl. Simply dominant, it's easy to envision him being one of the top quarterbacks for many years to come.
Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. That's sack courtesy of the effort of Hassan Reddick. Just not much a quarterback can do there, CD. The pressure was in his face almost instantaneously, led to a very quick sack.
And this came from the edge, and those pass rushers, they have so many tricks of the trade to get around blockers. They have a lot of tools in their kit. This was pure speed and athleticism on this play, though, and they could barely get a glove on him before he got the quarterback on the ground.
Here's Jerick McKinnon, his first carry of the ball game. Up past the 25 to the 26, a gain of 5.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. To throw, it's Mahomes. Man open, that's Marquez Valdes-Scantling. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
That certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that a play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
First down run as he gets his forward for about 8 or 9. That looks to be 8 officially, so 2nd and 2. But you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, 2nd and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
Roll, 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's 2nd and a couple. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. 7 yards there and a first down. A couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for. Right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time. That's what you're looking for in setting a tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive. On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Now they'll throw with Mahomes. This one complete to Mecole Hardman. And they're going to work this down to about the 32-yard line.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. He needed 2, he got 1, and that's going to leave him with 4th down and a yard.
Well, they picked up a portion of it, but not all that they needed. Now that leads to a decision on 4th and 1. Let's see what they decide to do.
So on 4th down, Mahomes off, Harrison Butker on for the Chiefs field goal. It'll be a 47-yard attempt from the left hash. Butker's kick here is good, and the Chiefs are out to a 3-0 lead. So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one-possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
After the field goal, here's Butker to kick it away. And this
Harris will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
The Eagles coming out as they get ready. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10. They start on the ground here at Sanders. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off. A pretty decent gain.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a 2nd and 5.
Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. On the throw, led him too much that time. It's incomplete.
They certainly thought he had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass.
Hurts sets up to throw it.
And this is going to be incomplete.
2 drives won't tell the story of this game, but you absolutely have to like how this defense has played thus far. They have yet to allow this offense to get on track in this one.
Here's Brett Kern now to punt this one away. Gets it here to right around the 24 before he's out of bounds. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And it's Chiefs football, 1st and 10. First down is Mahomes. Finding Hardman here over the middle. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
You always worry about those smaller receivers running through that gnarly patch of land in the middle of the field. But he did a really nice job there holding on to the football and protected himself as best he could while completing the play.
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Mahomes going to throw. And this one caught by Travis Kelce.
And they're going to get this up to midfield.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on 1st down. Mahomes taps this forward. It's a jet sweep.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before you get much out of it.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. On 2nd and 7, Mahomes throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
Had an open man that time. They ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. Mahomes now to throw. It's Kelce on the ground.
And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 29-yard line. Nice play for Kansas City, picking up the first 18 yards that time.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds him for the first down.
They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and 10. Mahomes' throw here complete to Kelce. And they're going to get this down inside the 15.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
There's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes firing quickly here, and that's complete. It'll be a gain of five, and that'll bring up second down.
Timing is so important on a route like this because he's going to line up out right and then cut straight across the field. I think the ball might have come out a count or two too late because by the time he was able to secure it, not much of a chance to turn it upfield.
From the 9, second and 5. Here's McKinnon on the draw. He pushes forward from maybe 3 down to the 6-yard line.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Play number 3rd and 2. Now Mahomes escaping the pressure right. And he'll just chuck this one up into row G. It's incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. For it. It's Mahomes. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete. Andy Reid went for it, but it won't pan out. And the Eagles defense able to hold.
Now that's just simply good coaching and excellent technique on that play. You know why? Because everyone wants to rush the passer when they want to throw the football, but you're not always going to get there. So what are you taught to do? When the ball's finally thrown, get your hands up in the passing lanes, and they batted that one away.
No, 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 no. On first down, Hurts. And this one caught along the sideline, but they say already out of bounds. And the throw didn't give him a chance to turn it upfield, and that brings up second down.
The defender certainly didn't forget about him leaking out of the backfield. There was a guy ready and waiting to pick him up in coverage, and that throw had no shot.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Hurts a handoff to Sanders. And he'll take this forward only up to about the 7. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with 3rd and 9 looming.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in the expected passing situation.
Hurts. Yards that time. And now they're in a fourth down situation.
And Parker, I would guess that in his headset, he was hearing from his coach, it's 3rd down, don't take a sack. And in this case, he's able to avoid the pressure and get out of there. He doesn't get the first down, but he does turn a possible loss into positive yardage.
Here's Brett Kern now, standing about a yard deep in his own end zone. And he's getting a workout here in this first quarter as he gets it away. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And that will come the offense as they take over. And now here comes Kansas City. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start first and 10. Play action. Now it's Mahomes. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. They'll wind up getting just a yard out of it, and it's second down.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. But linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
Looking to throw again on second down. Mahomes caught. Kelce left side. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied too quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that, you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch. Now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
That's interference. Defense.
So the penalty rightfully declined. They'll keep the yardage on the completion.
Still some disagreement by the defense, though, because he thought that was just good, strong coverage, and the contact's going both ways, so why is there a flag? In the end, though, doesn't matter. It's still a completed pass.
From the gun, they will run with McKinnon. No gain on the play there, second down. Defensively, though, they had a chance there to hit him for a loss, couldn't get it done.
Looked like someone was able to knife into the backfield, but he wasn't able to get him down. But his compatriots, they were able to grab him at the line of scrimmage and not let him get any further downfield.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. From the gun, it's Mahomes. Pressure comes, and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Hassan Reddick, his second sack of the night.
How about that part? His second sack of the game, and that puts him in some pretty good company. 17 guys have had 2 sacks in the previous 52 Super Bowls, but only 3 have had the record number of 3 sacks in this game.
And we've got the list here. If he gets another one and everyone behaves nicely, we might just list those out for him. Going to need better protection here. Third and long following the sack for Mahomes and company. He'll look to throw. Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. And this will be incomplete. Both players with a shot at it that time, but neither coming away with it.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10. Throwing is Hurts. Throw right side, caught by Goddard, the tight end. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
Now second and seven from the 23. They go play action with Hurts. Wide open is Watkins. He's got him. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards to pick up there.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Play action. Here's Hurts. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down. One quarter done, three more to play here in Super Bowl 57. 3-0 is our score. The NFL on EA Sports continues right after this message. And we are back and ready to go for the second quarter of the Super Bowl. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis, as always, thrilled to be with you. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
How about this defense? They came up with a couple big plays in this sequence, and none better than the one right there, forcing the incompletion and bringing up fourth down.
Here's Brett Kern now, as he's on to punt for the fourth time tonight. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it. And they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line. KC's offense ready to take over. And it's been very much a slow start for them. Three drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is one. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 11. They'll try and start this drive in the air. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. Hassan Reddick bringing the pressure yet again. That's his third sack here tonight.
And that's his third sack, and that ties a Super Bowl record. Makes me think of my old college teammate, Reggie White. He had three with the Green Bay Packers in Super Bowl 31. Darnell Dockett of Arizona, Super Bowl 43. And Coney Ealy, three sacks for the Panthers against Denver in Super Bowl 50.
All those sacks, they've only been an official record since Super Bowl 17. I know it's believed that L.C. Greenwood unofficially had four way back in Super Bowl 10.
Wearing those golden high tops as well.
Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Another try after the first down sack. Mahomes throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And third and 8 now.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back and it can turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
The Chiefs on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 8. Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. And got his man complete. A big play there for KC. 42 yards.
Now that one hurts defensively. They force him into third at the advantage, yet they give up the big play right there.
Yeah, their offense was already warming up on the sideline, ready to come out. So much for that three and out. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. Now here's Mahomes.
completes it to Hardman.
And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and it'll be second down. Two minutes gone by, second quarter. Now it's Mahomes again. He finds McKinnon, complete. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 31-yard line. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here.
Well, they've certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting instead of being aggressive and making plays.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. On play action, it's Mahomes. Catch is made by Hardman. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Mecole Hardman, 31 yards. As his guys are able to extend their lead.
Wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, right after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. That time, a 6-play drive, and it's capped off with a Kansas City touchdown. Touchdown. Here's Butker on to kick it away. This taken in at the goal line. And able to get this out to the 25. Philadelphia's offense ready to go again. Nothing for them yet from an offensive standpoint. Down 10-0 as they come up first and 10. Here's Hurts to throw. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he could break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. They'll come up now second and 4 from the 31. Hurts sets up to throw it. He finds his tight end, Goddard. That's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That'll be a pickup of 10 as they try to recover from this 10-point deficit.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
Shotgun snap, and then the give to Sanders. And he takes it past the 45 and down at the 46. Nick Bolton there on the tackle.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. Back to throw here. This is complete to Watkins on a slant. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 47.
Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here in this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get two more stops and escape this drive.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10.
From the gun, it's Hurts. Fires the quick slant. A.J. Brown's got it. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2. They'll try and run for it with Sanders. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. They're able to convert with a gain of 4.
A lot of different formulas to winning football, but one constant over the years, winning on 3rd down. That pickup there was big because they had struggled throughout this one.
Now here's 1st and 10. They'll set up a throw. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete.
And he'll be hauled down at about the 30-yard line.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing.
Coming up on a 2nd and 6.
Dances by at the 20. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A really nice effort that time. 12 yards on the keeper, picking up the first.
Right, nothing crazy. Just find a way to pick up the first down. A nice run right there.
So from inside the 20, here's 1st and 10 at the 18.
They'll run with Sanders up the middle, and they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down.
That's a strong pickup right there on 1st down, and as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5.
An option handoff given to Sanders.
And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a third down and four now.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
The offense on third down tonight, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third and four.
They'll look to throw here. Well, that's complete to Sanders. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. It'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And that's going to make it fourth down.
And that's a great job of tackling right there. If he could have made the first man miss, maybe he could have taken it into the end zone. Instead, they stopped him pretty well right in his tracks. And you often see that in the red zone. Offense has to be quick. In this case, the defense was quicker.
So Hurts is off, and on comes Jake Elliott for the Eagle field goal.
A 33-yarder from the left hash.
The kick by Elliott is good.
And they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3.
So 3 points there, and CD, that helps them inch a bit closer.
Yeah, partner, when you're losing, any points you see go on the board in your favor, you're happy to take them.
After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
Set to take over, Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs. 5 for 5 that last drive, touchdown pass as well. He was clicking. Receivers, I don't want to be cliche, but running really solid routes too.
And what I love about it is when you look across any team, all right, the body types of the receivers are usually different. The way that they get open, different as well. Some of them use power to get open. Some of them use those head fakes and subtle moves. Some of them just use pure speed. And the really good ones, when they're established, they know how to push off at the end of a route, too.
Now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Now Mahomes. Into the hands of Smith-Schuster on the crossing pattern.
And he gets this one just shy of the 35 to the 34.
That one a gain of 20 and a first down.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Mahomes gonna throw. Eluding the pressure right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Oh, I saw this one with defensive eyes because even as he escaped the pocket and bought time, the coverage stayed tight. Nothing broke down. Throwing it away, that was his only option.
From the 34, they'll come to the line on 2nd and 10. Looking to throw is Mahomes. He's going to launch this thing way downfield.
Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted.
Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And the Eagles are going to take over at their own 28-yard line.
Parker, I think this one went awry very simply because he overestimated his arm strength and his ability to fit it anywhere he wants to. A lot of quarterbacks do that and often pay the price.
With that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants to drive in with a kick other than the extra point. That's it.
because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
The last run got six, now second and four. Another run with Sanders. And he'll be brought down shy of the 38-yard line. 4 yards, the pickup, first down.
Now that's the way to do it.
First and 10, it's Hurts. Able to tiptoe his way out of bounds. A gain of four last play. They double that here and get eight.
Especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
It's a second down run with Sanders. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 42 yards rushing. First and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 47. Hurts. Just a gain of a couple.
Those just perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
And a line to gain here is the 37 on third down. Throwing is Hurts. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the five. They're able to convert on third down and then first and goal.
That is the exact right play call against that defense. So a hat tip to the offensive play caller because he won that part of the chess match. But give credit to his players as well. They won the execution part of it.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the five. They'll run with Sanders. He gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the six inside the five.
Twice, but I often think that second down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the and think about it being four down territory.
What a stand so far defensively, and now that's going to bring up a fourth and goal. This is a long drive offensively.
This is the time to go and put six on the board.
Going for it with Sanders. And he's in. Touchdown, Eagles. Miles Sanders taking it out. And the Eagles are an extra point away from tying up this Super Bowl. As the kick's away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And out a little across the 25. And out come the Chiefs now. They had the interception on the last drive, which led to the tying touchdown. So 2-4 as they begin first and 10. Down. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to.
Throwing now is Mahomes. Got an open man. It's Valdez-Scantling. The Chiefs will try and get to the line quickly. From the 45 on second down, Mahomes, he'll find Smith-Schuster, that's complete. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Mahomes finding Juju there for the Kansas City first. Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. This pass going to be caught by Hardman. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. First and 10. Here's Mahomes. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half.
missed an opportunity.
7th play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Here's Mahomes to throw. Flush to his right. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So on fourth down, Mahomes off, Harrison Butker on for the Chiefs field goal. He was true on his first, this a tough one from 49 yards away. Butker's kick here is good, and they will take the lead at 13-10.
Well, in a close game like this, obviously you want the touchdown, but certainly they will take the three.
And they'll be okay with that, but let's throw a little credit to the defense as well. I'm just glad this doesn't come down to a debate, right? Which side won, partner? Because the defense, hey, we didn't give up a touchdown. The offense, hey, we put three on the board. Either way you look at it, I think both sides gained something out of that drive.
Just outside the goal line. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. The Eagles offense going to take over late in this first half. And with him trailing, there is still enough time to try to string a few plays together, maybe get into field goal range.
Just over 30 seconds to go in the half. They've got it first and 10. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Over the middle, he's got Watkins. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play.
Throw on first down with Hurts. Open man, that's Devontae Smith.
And he takes us up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down.
Here's Hurts to throw.
Wide open is Watkins. He's got it.
And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line.
It's halftime here on sports' grandest stage in the Super Bowl. As now we send you out to Orlando and hook back up with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in everyone to our downtown Orlando studios in this EA Sports Halftime Report. First, though, a check of the next-gen stats in that first half for Kansas City. And it's been the passing game that's gotten them to where they are, two quarters away from a possible Super Bowl title. Meanwhile, for the Eagles, they too were able to take advantage of a soft secondary, as both of these two teams really threw the ball at will in that first half.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three.
Go lit up!
These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in this Super Bowl. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three.
And I think you'd have to say their coaching staff, all things considered, had to be pleased with their performance in the first half of this Super Bowl.
Definitely pleased. Doing their best not to show it to their team, of course, because as you and I both know, their mantra all season long has been finish. Get the job done. They know how close they are to lifting that trophy. One more solid half of football, and they can do exactly that.
Mahomes now on first down. That's going to be complete on the sideline, but, you know, that throw left him no room to run, and the good footwork nearly all for naught. 3 yards there to begin the third quarter. They also lead by 3 points.
Was that a receiver? Yeah, actually it was. It was a running back who was a receiver on the play. Ikey's been spending time in the receiver drills getting his feet down.
Well, those guys out of the backfield, they got to be good, agile with their feet. He showed the agility there with a toe tap.
No doubt about it. It's like he'd went to ballet school. Got the toes down and stayed in bounds.
The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And now it's 3rd and 3. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. Mahomes looks to throw on 3rd down. He's got his man, Valdez-Scantling. And he will have the Chiefs' 1st down. It's a gain of 6 that time on 3rd and 2. Facing some coverage, and he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene. That's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. He can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz game, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
And able to steer clear of that first tackler as he works his way forward for about 4.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Mahomes now to throw. Completes it to Hardman. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. His first catch of this 3rd quarter, he had 7 in the 1st half. It's also a 1st down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in the play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Couple of 1st downs to kick off the drive. Here's 1st and 10 up at the 46. Straight ahead they go with McKinnon. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11.
Sometimes being a linebacker in the middle of the field is kind of like being a doctor on the field. You got to make the right diagnosis. Here he correctly sets his run and shoots through to make the play in the backfield.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on 2nd down and 11. Meanwhile, Mahomes throw into the hands here of Hardman. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for 3rd down. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
On 3rd down, they're going to run for it here. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
That's a tremendous group effort there, because when you talk about offensive lines, the best ones, talk about guys that play in harmony, in sync, and getting things done, and they did that on that play.
Yeah, especially on 3rd and 1, got to be in sync, and they were.
Right back to him on first down. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
On second and 11 now, Mahomes. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. A gain of 8 there on the play. And this will wind up being a 3rd and 3.
If you run an out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
And he'll be tackled about 2 yards shy of the line to gain. A 1 yard pickup leads to 4th down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the 3rd quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
And this defense not ready for that one as he'll take this down inside the 25. That's a 4th down pickup of 10 yards and an opportunity certainly missed on the defensive side.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
So after the 4th down conversion, now 1st and 10 inside the 25. From the gun, it's Mahomes. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's going to be brought down at about the 16.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
To throw again on 2nd down, Mahomes. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay game.
And he's got the 1st down as he gets it to the 8. 41 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. So another 3rd down conversion, and now they've got a 1st and goal. Now here's Mahomes. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at 2nd down.
Well, that's a defense coordinator's got to be happy with that result. They took away all options downfield and forced the incompletion.
Nothing on 1st down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, 2nd and goal. To throw, it's Mahomes. And he comes back with one complete. And in for the Chiefs touchdown. Juju Smith-Schuster on a touchdown pass from Patrick Mahomes. And the Chiefs take the opening kickoff of the 3rd quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Circle that drive because that might be one to remember, well executed to give them a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because it was jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and his guys will take a 10-point lead.
The 20 to about the 22.
So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half.
Well, the opposition laid down the challenge, an opening drive touchdown here to start the second half. And Charles, now you feel like this group needs to get an answer because this all of a sudden is a two-score game.
Yeah, you're right about that. What was a small, manageable spread to overcome? A little bit more daunting now. I think you're exactly right. Pressure is on because you don't want them getting the ball back with a chance to really extend this lead out.
But first down, Hurts. Quick slant to Brown. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards picking up the first. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Here's Sanders, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. From the 36, Hurts. Throw right side, caught by Goddard, the tight end. Yeah, that's good for a gain of 6, and now it's 3rd and 3.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would admit that there was an incompletion and would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion, but I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication, and as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating, there he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Yeah, I know. I know they're on their own side of the field.
I was going to say.
Normally, I would say punt the ball away, but I'm feeling it. I say go for it.
Here's Brett Kern now, as he'll come on for his 5th kick of the night. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And this one hits at the 1, continues on into the end zone for a touchback.
There's McCole Hardman as he brings this offense onto the field yet again.
Good day for him so far here in the 3rd quarter. He's hit pay dirt once, over 100 yards, but hey, it's the 3rd quarter. He's thinking, I want more, right?
He wants more, and it just increases the confidence of his team, because every play he makes, that means his quarterback is really feeling good about throwing the football. Probably feels like he can't throw an incomplete pass when he throws it to him right now.
Yeah, he's looked really, really sharp. They'll start on the ground here on first down. And some room to work. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
Well, as we've learned over the years, just because a guy plays left tackle,
doesn't mean he doesn't have running blocks and abilities, and we just saw it there. Controlled the line of scrimmage, created a big game.
That's kind of a bonus. He's there to protect that high value that you have back under center, but he creates space in the run game.
Yeah, not only can he dance, he can mash too.
On first down, Mahomes. It's Kelce on the ground. So 5 yards here, five on the play, and it'll be second down.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You talk about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball, he's going to be tough to bring down.
Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3 yard gain brings up a third down. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. On third down, they're going to run for it here. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Here's the Chiefs punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is, can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them will be, but still all in all, a positive play for the offense. It's all about picking up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on second down.
Now second and seven from the 23. They'll go again with Sanders. Gets by him at the 25. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. 64 yards rushing for him now as he's done it on 19 carries.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Hurts sets up to throw it. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And they'll have a second and one forthcoming. That tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point that continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete.
At this point in the game, in the situation they're in, partner, these incompletions that we're seeing, they need to turn into positive snaps, and soon.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They run with Sanders off the option, and he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
Thinking on defense there. That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you ought to have a few men in the box there.
So two first downs, and that moves the ball to the 42 now, first and 10. Hurts going to give it to Sanders on the option. And able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47.
Not a huge play, but I think they're more than happy with how it turned out. Don't be surprised to see them revisit that call, because there was a lane there for more than just 5 yards. Put in your back pocket and break it out when you need it later.
From the 47, it's second and 5. Hurts. He's got Dallas Goedert, his tight end, over the middle. And he'll be taken down by number 45.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw it, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 45-yard line. Throwing is Hurts. That's swung out wide to Sanders. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And it'll bring up a second and short.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way. And really, we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
Here's the option going left on second down. And able to get this to the 24-yard line. They began the play at the 12. It's also a pickup of 12 for the first down.
I tell you, there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react. Even as quarterbacks carry the ball more and more in today's NFL, they're still a little bit in disbelief and realize, oh my goodness, he's running with the ball. He may be 8, 10, 12 yards downfield at that point.
A give running left. It's Sanders. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If he gets strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage. Rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. He'll drop to throw. Forced out to his left. And they're going to get this down inside the 15.
There he goes, and for good reason. Running with it has paid dividends earlier in this game and earlier on this drive. And until they prove they can stop him, I don't think he's going to be shy about continuing to run for first downs instead of airing it out.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. An option handoff given to Sanders. And he'll get about 3 just outside the 10, stopped at the 11.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Second down, back to Sanders. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Eagles are able to get a score back in the final stages of this third quarter. He's having a nice little game. Maybe already has an eye on that third touchdown.
How about what our producer, Christian McLeod, likes to say when they score touchdowns like this? Tend up in touchdown city.
Elliott on for the extra point. It's up and good, and the lead's now down to 3 at 20-17. So that one, a
13-play drive in total. And it was Miles Sanders who finished it off with a touchdown run. Too deep. Here comes a return. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. Their lead down to a field goal now as they start with a first and 10. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. It's a pickup of 6, and that is going to do it for this third quarter.
Just one more quarter remains in the season-long race for the Lombardi Trophy here at Super Bowl 57 from Glendale.
We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. Working from the gun, Mahomes. That's caught left side by Hardman. And Mahomes finding his burner, Hardman, for the KC first. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now Mahomes.
Slant route. That's complete to Travis Kelce.
And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone.
Only needing 2 yards on second down. Hands it off out of the gun.
And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front 7, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing. Slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
A couple of first downs on the drive already, as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. Mahomes taps this forward, it's a jet sweep. And he is going to lose yardage here. Second and 14. Mahomes going to throw. This pass going to be caught by Hardman. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 41-yard line. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
These guys certainly are not hiding what their intention is. They're absolutely showing it. They're definitely not going to sit on this lead here in the fourth quarter.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 41. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of 6, and it will set him back for second down.
And you're lateral to the line of scrimmage. Linebackers keep those shoulders square so they can go up and down. But when it's time to go, turn your shoulders just like a running back. Get through the line,
and hit the runner in the backfield.
If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. Here's Mahomes to throw. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And the Eagles are right back in this football game. A seismic shift in momentum here in the fourth quarter. That's the break that the defense needed.
And you know as well as I do, people are going to question the play call in that situation. Sometimes you have to question the execution, not necessarily the call. And in this case, those defenders found a way to give their team a chance.
Philadelphia's offense ready to give us another look. And this could become a career-defining drive for some. Down three, fourth quarter of the Super Bowl. This is where the legends are made in the National Football League as they begin this drive first and 10. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Now they go screen. It's complete. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield.
And a really nice play call there to start the drive, especially if you're a team that has a little bit of a reputation for throwing it downfield. You come out, and you think maybe you can catch them off guard a little bit, and they did. Little screen pass, backdoored them, and that time worked well for a solid game.
They run with Sanders off the option. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Here's Hurts to throw. It's caught by Sanders. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43.
And that's a gutsy call there on third and short because that's a play that's got a good chance of being blown up in the backfield for a big loss of yardage. But nice job out wide to gather in that screen pass, use his blockers well, and pick up the first down.
Hurts going to give it to Sanders on the option. He finds a little bit of room, enough for 4 yards. It'll be second down.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. An option handoff given to Sanders. And he only manages a couple here down to about the 38-yard line.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
Third down, trying to get a little bit closer. From here, the field goal would be 55 yards. They're going to look to throw. And this is caught, but I don't think he stayed in bounds. No, he didn't. It's incomplete. The throw took him past the boundary, and it's 4.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And that is no good. And instead of tying it up, they remain down by 3. A fourth quarter miss like that, there is no lonelier feeling than that kicker right now.
As we all know, a lot of these games, they come down to special teams. And when that chance comes, you have to perform in order to help your team get over the top.
Could have tied it. Instead, they remain down 3. The Chiefs' offense set to go. And the tension ratcheting up all around. A one-score game. Fourth quarter of the Super Bowl. This is what you folks came for. Every play with the potential to win or lose a title as they look to drain some time off this clock.
The Chiefs in good position to start out as they come up first and 10 at the 45. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive.
He's going to take a shot right away for the end zone.
And this is incomplete. Oh, he had 6 points right in his hands but could not hang on.
I know you felt like saying touchdown there, didn't you, partner? That looked like a sure 6 points, but the contact jarred it free.
Got his hands on it, could not hold on through the end of the play. Mahomes again here on second and 10. The tight end Kelce has it over the middle. 5 yards, now it's third and 5. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
The Eagles call on the extra defensive back here as they prepare for a stop on third down. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And that will be incomplete. Critical play in this football game, because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them, because they know that they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock, really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
Here's the Chiefs punter now, as he's on to kick it away. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And we're at the time of the Super Bowl where, look, they need points. And they need them badly, trailing here in the fourth quarter. They'll start this drive out on the ground. Still leave him with a third down.
Well, this has certainly turned into a showcase game for what he can do on the ground, because they're just continuing to give him chances to run it, and he's earning every additional carry by putting up positive yardage on each run.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. No. Second down.
That was a simple throw and catch.
They were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly.
Second and 10.
there.
So how about this for field position after the big play inside?
This ball game.
They'll run the jet sweep with Brown. And now they'll have it first and goal. Well, we've seen
as many people as it takes to slowing him down running the football. Even if they want to hit me over the top on play action, I just don't let him beat me that way anymore. And if I'm him, I'm in the huddle calling the plays myself. I don't care what play call comes in, I tell my quarterback, guess.
And if I'm the quarterback, I'm saying, okay, that sounds good, right?
Smart quarterback.
Elliott good with a PAT. And Miles Sanders, who finished it off with a touchdown run. Touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Taken at the goal line. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over.
Now the bad news for them, they've seen that cushion they once had totally evaporate, and they're working from behind. The good news, they now have the opportunity to regain the lead right back.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 23. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Open man completes it to Smith-Schuster. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
From all the way up at the 38 now after a good start to the drive. They fake the give. Now Mahomes. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Looked like a pretty good safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy on the flag.
Yeah, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down. A nice safe throw and a good one.
2 yards on the pickup, and that's all they needed to move the sticks.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes. Got an open man. It's Valdez-Scantling. And he'll be dropped just shy of the 35 at the 34. A pickup of 17 on a play that originated at the 17.
Well, this is where reading defenses and practice time comes into play. You got to know what you're running versus zone versus man and how to run the proper route. And they just executed that one pretty well.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 34. Looking to throw is Mahomes. It's Kelce on the ground.
And they're going to move it down inside the 25.
Charles, he's now over 400 yards passing in this one. It feels like he has a zillion completions. Just a very memorable effort from a guy that we thought could be in line for a big game, and he has exceeded our expectations.
That he has, and I'm not really surprised at all, because when you look at this offensive unit, they are loaded across the board. And, of course, the guy throwing them, he's a big-time player himself. They brought it from start to finish and really helped get the better of the opposing secondary.
And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Mahomes to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle, so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Mahomes on the slant, he's got Hardman, and the Chiefs are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5.
Well, they have had no answer for this connection all night long.
They just have to think, in a 2-minute situation, that's got to be a concentration lapse. You know they're going to go back to him with the game that he's been having.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown, and that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Steps away to his left. This is caught. Touchdown! Jarek McKinnon. A 5-yard touchdown. And the Chiefs have regained the lead in the second half of this Super Bowl.
See, it seemed like they were so focused on the guys out wide, they forgot about him out of the backfield.
That's a really good point, because you've got to communicate, and oftentimes when you start counting receivers, that's exactly what you do. You start from the widest receiver, work your way inside. Who gets lost sometimes? The back in the backfield. That's exactly what happened there.
And he got into the end zone. Extra point by Butker is on target. So it's now a 3-point game here in the closing stages, as a field goal now can only tie it. Deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone, and he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Hurts and the Eagles now down 27-24, 80 seconds remaining. They need at least a field goal to send this Super Bowl to overtime as they come up on first down. To throw. Well, that's complete to Sanders. Well, first down screen pass, good for 5.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play. let the clock wind down.
Hurts trying to hurry up the offense.
They'll look to throw.
And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49.
Hurts dangerous when he runs that football. He's got a first.
The Eagles hustling to the line, clock rolling. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. Back to throw. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about, and you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. He'll look to throw. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 22 ticks to go in the fourth. A field goal from this spot likely out of the question. They've got to get closer here on third down. He's back to throw. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here. Fourth down now defensively. Charles, you know, they're just asking this crew for one more stop.
And you know that they're feeling the momentum right now, but they have to be very careful not to get over-exuberant, over-excited, and blow an assignment and give up the big first down.
They're going on fourth down with Hurts. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and that may write a finish to this Super Bowl. Victory in the cards now for the Chiefs as they take a knee here. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ball game. Time for this one final knee to put a bow on this title bout. Super Bowl champions, they etch their name forever in NFL immortality.
That's pretty phenomenal right there. It actually gave me chills just to hear you say that, because immortality forever and ever. When you look in the record books, you'll see this team, you'll see their picture, that your name will be a part of it. That's got to be an incredible feeling, because it's been a long journey to get there, and now they get a chance to enjoy it.
You gotta choose. You like the top or you just like the loose.